Okay, today we discuss about the cycloconverter. Now content of today's lecture is introduction about cycloconverter, need of cycloconverter, classification of cycloconverter, working principle of cycloconverter, and if time permit then we will discuss about the center types of cycloconverter. Okay, so first of all, introduction of cycloconverter. The cycloconverter is a device that converts AC power of certain frequency to AC power of another frequency. Okay, so it is a one type of converter which converts AC power into AC power. Okay, so whatever input we are giving to the cycloconverter is AC, and whatever output we are taken from the cycloconverter is also AC. So it is known as the AC to AC converter. Why it is known as the AC to AC converter? Because the input given to the cycloconverter is AC, as well as the output we are getting from the cycloconverter is also AC. That's why it is known as the AC to AC converter. Okay, so now what happens, what we are giving input to the cycloconverter, that is the fixed voltage, fixed frequency AC. Suppose the input given to the cycloconverter is fixed voltage, fixed frequency AC input, then we are getting the output, that is variable frequency, variable voltage AC output. Okay, so we can say that if voltage is fixed or frequency is fixed, then we get a variable voltage or variable frequency. So we can say that it converts the frequency without help of any intermediate DC link. Okay, here we are changing the frequency, or we are converting the frequency using the cycloconverter. So we can say that cycloconverter converts the frequency without help of any intermediate DC link. There is no intermediate DC link in the cycloconverters. Okay, and the output voltage and frequency of a cycloconverter can be varied continuously and independently using a control circuit. Okay, so here what happens, it converts the AC input power into the AC output power. Okay, so another name of the cycloconverter is also single stage frequency converter. It converts the frequency in only one single stage. That's why it is a single stage frequency converter also. Okay, so cycloconverter converts the AC power into AC power with desired frequency and voltage. So it is known as the cycloconverter. It converts frequency without any intermediate DC link. Okay, it is also a single stage frequency converter. Okay, cycloconverters are constructed using naturally commutated thyristor. Okay, the name the thyristor used is of naturally commutated thyristor. Why naturally commutated thyristor? That means the we are not making thyristor off externally. Okay, the thyristor becomes off naturally. Okay, how naturally commutated thyristor? That means when the waveform value becomes zero, at that time the thyristor becomes off naturally. So we do not have to make the thyristor off forcefully. So force commutation is not used. Here is the only natural commutation is used to make the thyristor off. Okay, so it is constructed using the naturally commutated thyristor. Control circuit implementation is not simple because large number of SCRs, typically 4 or 8 SCRs for single phase and 36 for three phase supply is required. Okay, here what happens, the more number of SCRs are used, whether it is of 4 or 8 or 36 SCRs. Okay, so as the number of SCRs increase, what happens, the control circuit implementation is very complicated, or it becomes complex because of the more number of SCRs are used. For such controller, a microcontroller or microprocessor or DSP is used to trigger the SCR. If the number of SCRs are used, so control circuit becomes complicated, and for that the controller is used like microcontroller or microprocessor or digital signal processor to trigger the SCRs. Okay, so now why the cycloconverter is required? Okay, So need of cyclo converter, the answer is of this question is the speed controller. Okay, why cyclo converter is required, and the answer is the speed control. Okay, so cyclo converters are extensively used for driving large motors like one used in rolling mills, ball mills, cement mills, etc. Okay, so how can we control the speed? So we can control the speed by changing the frequency. Okay, so the out frequency of a cyclo converter can be reduced up to zero, which helps us to start very large motor with full load at minimum speed and then gradually increase the speed of motor by increasing the output frequency. Okay, so by changing or by varying the frequency, we can adjust the speed of motor. Okay, so with the help of cyclo converter, we can adjust or we can increase or decrease the frequency as per the requirement, and according to that we can control the speed. Before the invention of cyclo converter, this large motor has to be unloaded completely. Okay, so when cyclo converters are not invented at that time, how can we adjust the speed? So first we have to unloading the large motors completely. That means we have to make the motors in no load condition. Okay, so whatever load connected on motors, we have to remove it first. Okay, and then after starting motor, it has to be loaded gradually, which results in time and manpower consumption. So before invention of cyclo converters, we have to make the speed control in this manner. Okay, so this is the need of cyclo converter, in which we have to control the speed of large motor. For that we have to vary or we have to adjust the frequency, and with the help of cyclo converters we can adjust or vary the speed of large motors. Okay, now the classification of cyclo converter. Okay, so we have a different types of cyclo converter. First we have a step up and step down cyclo converter. Second, we have a constant frequency input, variable frequency output, and variable frequency input, constant frequency output. Next is the single phase to single phase cyclo converter, in which we have a center tapped transformer type cyclo converter and bridge type cyclo converter. Okay, next is the three phase to single phase cyclo converter, and last one is the three phase to three phase cyclo converter. This is the classification of cyclo converter. So one by one we discuss what is the type of the cyclo converter. So first is step up and step down cyclo converter. Okay, we already studied the transformer, in which we already studied the step up transformer and step down transformer. Step up transformer, that means we are getting more voltage compared to the primary or secondary voltage is greater than the primary voltage. Okay, and step down, secondary voltage is lesser than the primary voltage. Okay, or the transformer which steps up the voltage is step up transformer, and the transformer which step downs the voltage, that is known as the step down transformer. Okay, so likewise here, step up and step down cyclo converter. So the cyclo converter in which output frequency F0 is more compared to the input frequency FI is known as step up cyclo converter. Okay, so the cyclo converter output frequency is more, or output frequency is greater than the input frequency. So F0 is greater than FI. Okay, so the cyclo converter in which output frequency F0 is greater compared to the input frequency is known as step up cyclo converter. Okay, the cyclo converter in which output frequency is less than input frequency is known as step down cyclo converter. So F0 is less than FI. So in step down cyclo converter, output frequency is less compared to the input frequency, Whereas in step up cycloconverter, output frequency is more compared to the input frequency. So on basis of input and output frequency, one classification is step up and step down cycloconverter. Okay, normally step down cycloconverters are there which are used in traction system to reduce losses in traction motor by reducing the frequency from 50 hertz to 16 into 2 by 3 hertz. Okay, normally the cycloconverters are of step down cycloconverter, and what is the application of it? Of the step down cycloconverter, it is used in a traction system. Okay, so by using the step down cycloconverter, we can reduce the frequency of traction motor from 50 hertz to 16 into 2 by 3 hertz. Okay, so as the frequency reduces, what happens? Losses in traction motor also reduces. Okay, so by using the step down cycloconverter, we can adjust the speed of traction motor. Next classification of cycloconverter is fixed frequency input, variable frequency output, and variable frequency input, fixed frequency output type cycloconverter. Okay, so if we compare these two, okay, fixed frequency, that is the constant frequency. So whatever input we are giving to the cycloconverter, that is of constant frequency type. So whatever input given to the cycloconverter has constant frequency, or we can say that fixed frequency, it will not change. Okay, or we cannot change the input frequency. Okay, so we are making the input frequency constant or fixed at one amount. Okay, and whatever output we are getting from this cycloconverter, that is of the variable frequency output. Okay, so here we are giving the fixed frequency input supply, and we are getting the variable frequency output. Okay, so it is known as the fixed frequency input, variable frequency output type cycloconverter. Whereas second one is, the input given to this cycloconverter is of variable frequency type, or variable frequency input is given to the cycloconverter, and we are getting fixed frequency output. Okay, so here we are giving the variable frequency input to the cycloconverter, and this cycloconverter gives fixed frequency output. So these are the two type, constant frequency or fixed frequency input, variable frequency output type cycloconverter, and variable frequency input, fixed frequency output type cycloconverter. Okay, now this type of cycloconverter is used to control the speed of AC motor. Fixed frequency input, variable frequency output type cycloconverter is used in to control the speed of AC motor, whereas variable frequency input, fixed frequency output type cycloconverter is used in aircraft and ship machines, also used in wind power generation. Now, in wind power generation, what happens? The force of wind is not constant. Sometimes the more force is coming, sometimes the less force is coming. So what happens? The frequency we are getting of the power generation is not constant. Okay, so for that we have to use such type of cycloconverter, variable frequency input. That means whatever output we are getting from the alternator, that is given to the cycloconverter. Okay, because what happens in wind power generation? Okay, wind force is going to the wind blade. Okay, and due to it, the wind rotates. Okay, windmill rotates, and this is connected with the alternator. So according to that, alternator generates voltage. But the wind force is not constant, so whatever output we are getting from the alternator has a variable frequency also. Okay, so this output is given to this cycloconverter, and this cycloconverter makes the constant frequency. Okay, so now we are getting the constant frequency output. This is the second type of cycloconverter. Now next is the single phase to single phase cyclo converter. Okay, the cyclo converter in which input is single phase AC and output is also single phase AC is known as single phase to single phase cyclo converter. Okay, input is single phase, output is also single phase, so it is known as single phase to single phase cyclo converter. It is whether of it is step up type cyclo converter or the step down type cyclo converter, and it is of mainly two type, center tapped transformer type and bridge type. In center tapped transformer type cyclo converter, the transformer is used which has tapping in the secondary winding. Okay, in center tap transformer type, the transformer is used and this transformer has a secondary winding in which tappings are provided. Okay, whereas in bridge type cyclo converter, transformer is not required. In center tap transformer type, 4 SCRs are required, whereas in bridge type cyclo converter, 8 SCRs are required. Okay, next classification is the three phase to single phase type cyclo converter. Okay, in a three phase to single phase cyclo converter, the input is the three phase AC, whereas the output is single phase. Okay, according to its name, three phase to single phase cyclo converter, input is three phase AC, whereas the output is only single phase AC. That's why it is known as three phase to single phase cyclo converter. And last one is three phase to three phase cyclo converter means the cyclo converter in which input is three phase AC and output is also three phase AC is known as three phase to single phase cyclo converter, and it is of two type, open delta type and ring type. So this is the classification of cyclo converter. Now the working principle of cyclo converter. Okay, the cyclo converter is made of two converters in which one converter works as a positive converter and second converter works as a negative converter. Okay, look at this circuit diagram. Okay, in this one is the positive converter, here it is indicated, this is the positive converter, that is P converter, here it is denoted by, or it works as a negative converter. Okay, it is made of two controlled rectifier connected in back to back. These are the two controlled rectifier, this is the one controlled rectifier, this is the second controlled rectifier. Okay, one controlled rectifier in the positive converter, another controlled rectifier is in the negative converter. Okay, so this one is works as a positive converter, this one is works as a negative converter. Okay, positive converter and negative converter are connected in anti-parallel, so both polarities can be applied to the load. Look at this circuit diagram. Okay, positive converter and negative converter both are connected anti-parallel. Okay, so what happens, both polarities can be applied to this load. Okay, here is the load, load is connected here. Okay, so both are connected in anti-parallel. Okay, so what happens, both polarities we can apply to the load. Okay, the firing angle of both converters is set such that it will change the output frequency. Okay, we have a two converters and we have to adjust the firing angle such that, okay, this is the one converter, this is the second converter. Okay, so we have to adjust the frequencies, firing angle such that we can change the output frequency. Okay, that is available here. Okay, so we can get the variable frequency, or we can change the output frequency using the firing, by setting the firing angles of this as controlled rectifier. Okay, the output voltage of both the converter becomes equal in p-type converter and n-type converter of ideal cyclo converter. Here we assume that the cyclo converter is ideal. Okay, so whatever output voltage of both converter, that is p-type converter and n-type converter, is equal, that is output voltage, that means here whatever voltage available across this load. Okay, so whatever output voltage is available here across the load, that is equal whether the positive converter works or negative converter works. So whatever output voltage available here is equal, that means the output voltage by positive converter as well as output voltage by negative converter is equal. Okay, so the output voltage at the terminal of cycloconverter is either of the alternating voltage of the converter, because each converter has equal alternating voltage amplitude as well as the same phase as well as the frequency. Okay, now the power flows from either load to converter or converter to load by controlling the firing angle of each converter. Okay, so the firing angle, if we adjust the firing angle, okay, so according to that the polarity comes across this load. Okay, so this is the positive converter, this is the negative converter. So as we make the firing of these two control rectifier, according to that we can get the polarity across this load, whether this terminal is positive or this terminal is positive, that depends on the firing of this control rectifier. Okay, so what happens, the P converter works in the positive half cycle of alternating supply and N converter works in the negative half cycle of the alternating supply. This means that each converter operates both in rectifying and inverting regions during the period of its associated half cycle. Okay, so what happens during positive half cycle? What happens? The P converter works. During negative half cycle, N converter works. Okay, so if we see this circuit diagram, so during positive half cycle this converter works, during negative half cycle this converter works. Okay, understood? So during positive half cycle this terminal becomes positive, this terminal becomes negative. During negative half cycle what happens? In this direction current will flow, and when it works in this direction current will flow. So the current during this converter, it is flowing in this direction, whereas in N converter current is flowing in this direction. Okay, so the direction of current is opposite. So if we assume the P converter operates at that time, it is the positive converter works when positive current is flowing, negative half cycle, during negative half cycle the negative converter works, and according to it, it is in the rectifying mode or inverting mode. Okay, whether the P type, it depends on the operation of P type converter and N type converter. This means each converter operates both in rectifying and inverting regions during the period of its associated half cycle. Okay, so power flows into the converter during the period in which the product of V and I, that is voltage and current, is positive and converter operates in rectifier mode. Okay, so here we have a two different waveform. Okay, this is the voltage waveform, this is the current waveform, here is also voltage waveform and current waveform. Okay, so power flows into the converter during the period in which the product of voltage and current is positive. Okay, so in this time duration, what happens? Current, product of current and voltage, so one here is current is in negative. Okay, so what happens in this time duration, the product of voltage and current is negative. Okay, in this time duration what happens, the product of voltage and current is positive. Once again, in this time duration the product of voltage and current is negative. Okay, now look at this waveform. So from this time duration to this time duration, in this time duration product of voltage and current is positive. Okay, whereas in this time duration the product of voltage and current is negative. Understood? So in this situation it is negative. Once again it is the product of this product voltage and current. Okay, here voltage is also negative, current is also negative. Okay, so the product is negative voltage and negative current. Okay, here one, what happens, the current is positive and voltage is negative. So it depends on the product of voltage and current. Okay, so during positive half cycle the positive converter works, during negative half cycle the negative converter works. So in this manner the cyclo converter will operate. Okay, so discuss about the introduction of the cyclo converter. Cyclo converter is a single stage frequency converter. It converts the frequency without help of any intermediate DC link. It converts AC power into AC power with desired frequency and voltage. Okay, the thyristor used is of naturally commutated thyristors. Okay, why cyclo converter is required? The answer is the speed control. Okay, so to control the speed of large AC motors, cyclo converter is used, and this cyclo converter is used to adjust the frequency, and according to that the speed can be controlled. Okay, in classification, step up step down cyclo converter. Okay, so step up cyclo converter means output frequency is greater than input frequency. Step down cyclo converter means output frequency is lesser than the input frequency. Fixed frequency input, variable frequency output, which is used to control the speed of AC motor, whereas variable frequency input, fixed frequency output type cyclo converter is used in aircraft and ship, and also used in wind power generation to make the output frequency constant. So output of alternator is connected to cyclo converter, so this cyclo converter gives the constant frequency. Okay, then single phase to single phase cyclo converter. Input is single phase, output is also single phase. It is of step up or step down type. Okay, in it is of two types, center tap type, in which center tap transformer is used, whereas in bridge type a transformer is not required. In center tap 4 SCRs are used, in bridge type 8 SCRs are used. Then three phase to three phase cyclo converter. The cyclo converter in which input is three phase, output is single phase is known as three phase to single phase cyclo converter. And last one is three phase to three phase means input is three phase, output is also three phase. It is of two type, open delta type and ring type. In working principle, we have two converters, positive converter which works in the positive half cycle, negative converter works in negative half cycle. Okay, so the polarity, or we can say that the firing of SCR control rectifier is adjusted such that then we can apply both the polarity, whether it is the positive or it is the positive. Okay, so we can apply both the polarity by adjusting the firing angle of control rectifier, and whether the output is coming to the load or coming from the load, that depends on the product of voltage and current. Okay, whether voltage and current is positive or product of voltage and current is negative, that depends on the polarity, or we can say that the power coming to the load or power coming from the load, that depends on the product of voltage and current. Okay, so we will stop here.